Olá pessoal, Gabriela Manzini, head de conteúdo do Digitalks, falando direto da Espanha. Estamos aqui no DES de Madrid, maior evento de transformação digital que a gente tem no momento aí no mundo. E eu estou aqui com a Blanca Trebinho, que é a presidente da Softtech, e a gente vai bater um papo um pouco sobre alguns aspectos estratégicos que a empresa está trabalhando em termos de transformação digital e um pouco do que ela vai falar hoje no painel, no palco principal. Tá legal? Hello, Blanca. How are you?
Hi, how are you? Bom dia. Obrigada, Gabi. Obrigada.
No problem.
I am so sorry that I cannot do this in Portuguese. Yeah, I wish I could, but anyway, I do understand. So if you want to do the questions in Portuguese, I can show you that I do understand because of the operation that we have in Brazil.
That's no problem. Blanca, to start with, the theme of the panel that you're going to participate, the talk show you're going to participate, how are you in Softtech addressing leadership in digital transformation?
You know what, it's interesting. When you think about digital transformation, I do believe that most leaders, no matter the industry or the kind of company, or even the economy, because also at a government level, you have to understand what is behind digital transformation and the kind of challenges that you face. Because if you don't understand that, then you'll be surprised about the disruption will come and hit you so hard. So the way that we approach leadership is really, it's not about just the leaders that we have in Softtech, but it's creating that awareness that because of the kind of company that we are, we have to be, in this case, leaders promoting or fostering digital transformation. So it's really making sure that, for example, Agile, it's part of our culture. Because when you think about digital transformation, agility, it's key. It's important how fast you can move and how fast you can in a way, transform or help that transformation. So it's really understanding that we should be leaders in this. When you think about supporting other companies, it's really creating the culture in our company, within our company, to understand the key elements about digital transformation. It is challenging, but I also believe that leaders, again, no matter the industry, we do face those kind of challenges, right? And that it's in a certain way exciting and also scary, what you can achieve when you understand digital transformation.
When you think about strategies, what are you guys in Softtech focusing on in this year?
Not just about digital transformation, yeah, right?
Yeah.
So we have always, our mission, we have always said that it's create value through technology. It has been the same mission. We have not changed that in the past 25 years. So what it's always changing, to your point, is a strategy that we have. So for this year, there are a few things. Obviously, keep on positioning ourselves as leaders in how we support our clients in through this process of digital transformation. It is also making sure that they understand that we have the experience related to digital transformation, but also a very profound, if you want to call it that way, experience of or understanding of very specific industries, no matter if it's retail or financial sector or CPE or whatever you might have. So this year is we're trying to align in a certain way that our approach to the market is not just as a technology company, but it's more from a consulting perspective saying, I've been working for you for the past 20 years. So I understand retail, I do understand CPE or financial sector or whatever, manufacturing. So I can translate that in the kind of, or I can understand the kind of challenges that you're facing related to digital transformation. So the second strategy is making sure that the market understands the experience that we have related to different industries. So they can expect to have that also that value. So it's not just the technical background or technological background or not just the digital transformation, but also that we can relate it to their industry. So that's the
second market itself.
Absolutely. And the third one, it's really, for example, we were not We're very strong in the Americas, a very strong presence. So if you go to Argentina or to the US or Mexico or Brazil, they know Softec very well, but not in Europe. So we are really trying to strengthen what we have in Europe. That's also something that is going to be key this year.
Well, you just mentioned that you're worldwide, just in this last question exactly. And if we could do a little bit of a parameter or a comparison between what you guys are seeing of digital transformation in Europe and what you guys see in digital transformation in South America or even Brazil, what are the main differences that you can see? What can maybe Brazilians leaders learn from digital transformation in Europe right now?
I think even though, and I will address that, there are differences between the different markets and countries for reasons that I will discuss. One thing that it's important, it's more and more you have global companies, right? So you can see in Brazil, huge global companies, leaders in the industry. So they are exposed to that those kind of challenges, no matter if they started in Brazil or their headquarters are in Brazil. They know that in order to compete as a global companies, they have to embrace in a certain way the digital transformation. So one thing it's important is that I truly believe that the awareness is there. I can say the concern is there, the understanding that if they don't really understand that digital transformation, their industry, their company might be disrupted very soon. So one thing that is positive, certainly at the different levels in the different markets, it's I do and strongly believe that in the different board meetings in most global companies, even if they're from Brazil or Mexico or Spain, this conversation it's today in the different board meetings. Years ago, technology will not be part of the agenda in the board meetings. So today, I think Brazilians, Mexican, Argentinians, or Chinese or Europeans, they have that awareness. Having said that, it is very obvious that Latin American countries sometimes are a little bit behind what is going on in this case, for example, the US. Mexico, it has this very strong influence from the US. We are neighbors, right? So I do believe that we move a little faster.
Okay.
But also something that it's interesting from my perspective is in some cases companies are either very excited, so they move very fast, or in a certain way care about the kind of things that you can do with technology. And think about cybersecurity, just to mention something, right? Some companies will say, I don't really get it. I don't understand, so I don't want to get into whatever, because something might expose me so much. And on the other side, you have those companies that are so excited about technology, think about analytics or whatever, that they jump in and start doing things that probably they will not get the kind of result that they expect because they did it so reactively without necessarily a plan, that you can see both things. But you find companies, I'm going to use one of the companies in Brazil, Natura.
Yeah,
it's
very
incredible.
Famous one.
It's incredible the way that the kind of things that they are doing related to digital transformation. If you go and see Itaú or whatever other company that you have there, I mentioned just two different ones, one CPG and the other financial,
yeah,
they are doing great. But you might find other companies in Brazil that are so way behind. In the US, in Europe, to your point, I do believe that it's a must, and most companies already have a strategy
it's
related to
it. It's more equal, maybe.
It's more equal. In Brazil, the more global, or in Latin America, the more global you are, I do believe the more involved also, or the you have stronger initiatives or strategies related to that. You see companies that are really talking a lot about agility, and it's interesting. They talk about agile, and if you go to Walmart Mexico, for example, it is a I mean, you can feel it even much more than Walmart, the U.S. Agility, agile teams, because it's part of that. It's not just the technology itself, but it's the culture that moves the company and the way that the teams work in order to get to there.
Perfect. And just to finish our conversation, one of the themes that you're going to say in the talk show today is about leadership in digital transformation and also diversity. And you, as a woman, as president of the company here, you have the total property to say how is Softex working diversity today in the company, and you can say globally or even to Europe.
Yeah, well, one thing that you have to understand, we're a service company. So our, if not the only one, our most important asset is talent. And talent has no gender, no age, no nothing, no nationality. So we always look for talent, regardless of, again, gender, age, whatever, nationality. So we do address that, not as a something that might be, okay, let's go and look for women, or let's do this something for women. We talk about talent without addressing or without making any kind of qualification. That's one thing, and it's very related to the kind of company that we're. Service company, your most important asset or your only asset, certainly your key differentiator is your talent. So that's one thing. The other thing, it's personally, I never wanted to position or to say, oh, these are the challenges or difficulties that we face as women. I like to say that I haven't faced any, that I'm just an executive or as a leader, and probably I don't want to pay attention to the things that other women said, because that's the way that I have been able to be here, without making any kind of excuse, without saying, okay, there are challenges, yes, but you can face them, and you can do and position yourself. So it's different. We like to think that talent has no gender, so that makes things much easier. Yes, I'm part of this team, not thinking about Softec, but when you go out to different events, it's great to have you here, Gabby, because you also you also can say what it's about being a woman. But I am part of different boards in which I might be the only woman, or you might go to different events in which there are very small percentage of women. But more and more we're making noise, and we are trying to say that. It's, for example, it's not about quotas. Sometimes you go to different countries and they are pushing so much companies to say you have to have at least that ratio. And I don't like quotas, because it's, from my perspective, it's disrespectful, because then when you sit on this event or in this panel or in this board, they might always question, oh, she's there not because of her talent or experience or whatever she can put on the table. It's because they had to face or reach that kind of quota. So I think that's the way that we have to see ourselves, that we have the right to be there, and that we should not necessarily be paying attention to our gender, much more to making sure that we show the kind of experience that we have, the talent that we have, and that we can add value wherever we are.
Well, thank you for your time, Blanca.
No, obrigada. Not many words, but obrigada, Gabi.
You have a great talk show in the auditorium right now. E a gente continua por aqui.